Hey everyone, this is Haley Marguerite, the children's author of the book Charlie Takes an Adventure. This book was written by myself, Haley Marguerite, and it was illustrated by Daniel J. Montenegro. Once upon a time, there was an adventurous penguin named Charles Ignatius Adelaide. Sit right back and relax because I'm about to tell you a story of a penguin that we call Charlie. What is the penguin's name? Charlie lives in the ancient city of Urds. Urds is located in Antarctica, where it's extremely cold. Brrr! Charlie's home is in the section of the town called Pickering Wharf. He doesn't like the wharf because he thinks there's nothing to do and no one to play with. Winter lasts a really long time in Antarctica. The days are really short and the nights are very long. It's so cold in Antarctica, if you're not careful, your eyeballs can freeze. Now, Charlie is a penguin, and he's supposed to like the cold weather, but Charlie doesn't like it at all. What is he supposed to do? So one day, while Charlie was waiting to get a haircut, he decided to look at some travel magazines that were left on the table. He grabbed the magazine that had palm trees and beaches on the cover. It was a travel magazine about Florida. Charlie read every word about traveling to Florida. It said, the weather is sunny and warm, the people are really nice, and there are plenty of things to do. After reading all the wonderful things about Florida, Charlie decided it was time for him to go. The very next day, Charlie set out on a plane to Florida, where there's warm weather, plenty of activities, and a whole lot of people to be with. Shortly after Charlie took a seat in the plane, the flight attendant said, "Everyone, please fasten your seatbelt." Charlie had never been in a plane before, and he wasn't sure what a seatbelt was. But Charlie watched other passengers and figured out how to put it on. 10 minutes after they were up in the air, the flight attendant spoke again. "Snacks and beverages will be served in a few minutes." When she came with the snacks and beverages, Charlie had his headphones on and was listening to music. The flight attendant asked Charlie, "What can I get for you?" He responded, "Fish." And the lady sitting next to Charlie with a pink polka-dotted dress just stared at him for a very long time. When Charlie stepped off the plane in Florida, he thought to himself, "Hello, sunshine. The weather is sunny and warm, just like the magazine said it would be." Charlie then took a cab to the Palm Bay Hotel in Coconut Grove. As the porter helped Charlie with his bags, he noticed the bags were really heavy and had a horrible rancid odor coming from within them. That means they smelled so bad. We're going to say, poor Charlie. Charlie explained that they were full of raw fish, mahi-mahi sushi, his favorite entree to eat. He brought them with him from Antarctica. Unfortunately, the warm weather was not good for Charlie's food. Later that day, Charlie decided to go to Miami Beach for a swim. When he arrived at the beach, Charlie observed a sign that read, "Sea lice today, no swimming." We're going to say, poor Charlie. Charlie was a bit disappointed, but assumed he could at least lie down and get a suntan. Within minutes, the sky became dark and started to rain like cats and dogs. We're going to say, poor Charlie. That night, Charlie thought it might be enjoyable to go to a party downstairs in the lobby of the hotel so he can spend some time with some new people. One of the reasons for Charlie's adventure was to meet new people, remember? So when Charlie arrived in the lobby, it seemed that everyone was delighted to see him. And this made Charlie smile. After about 10 minutes of walking in the party and mingling with the other guests, an elegantly dressed lady approached Charlie and asked to bring her a Shirley Temple. Charlie had no problem doing this because he thought perhaps she admired him. Charlie thought to himself, "This is great!" On Charlie's way back to the elegantly dressed lady with her glass in hand, three other people asked for the exact same thing. Charlie felt very popular, and this made him extremely happy. When Charlie dropped off the last glass, the gentleman said to Charlie, "It's always nice to have good help at these parties." Charlie replied.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.